right. Welcome to another edition of Singles Only Podcast. My name is Paul Farivar, as you know, and today we have a special side girl. Is that okay?
That's fine.
See, Jeannie does
not side woman. Side woman sounds weird.
Yeah, see, Jeannie and I got into a huge fight.
Do you not want to take my sidecar?
I don't want to take your sidecar.
You can take my sidecar.
No, I like side girl.
Side girl. All right,
but it's spelled with a G-U-R-R-L-L.
Girl.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Patty Vasquez joins me. Well, let me formally introduce Alia Janine. Yes. Thanks for coming.
Thanks for having me.
Alia is a friend of mine. She's a former porn star, and now she does comedy. Is that accurate to say?
Yeah, that's very accurate. That's pretty much it. That's what I do.
It's a good resume, though.
Yeah, well, I have a very eclectic resume when it comes to the jobs. Like, I went to school to be a cop and stuff, so I have a degree in police science. I'm going to school for forensic psychology right now. I used to work at a paper plate factory. I was an armored car driver. Used to suck dick for a living. Like, it's just the list goes on and on.
And what was your favorite job?
I like the dick sucking. Not, it was really, you know, I'm kind of good at it. It was nice, yeah.
So I have so many more questions on that. In that vein of
this
questioning.
This might be a two-part show.
No, go ahead.
So first of all, obviously you're single right now. Is that fair to say?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
On the hunt?
Are you looking to get settled down and get married someday?
No, I haven't looked for, I can't remember when. Like, I'm 38 now. Thank you. I know I look wonderful for my age.
You do look wonderful. You look wonderful, not for your age. You look wonderful, period.
Period.
I'm trying to, like, my last super serious relationship, it was with a director in porn. We dated for about a year. But that just, like, we met on set, and, like, we fucked well together. And we're like, let's do this more, like, off camera.
Okay.
And so we did that a lot, like a lot. There
What's the difference? Was it better when you guys had sex off camera or on, or was it both?
Well,
the same?
It was just more complicated on camera because, like, we like certain
80
angles.
People in the room. Yeah.
Well, no. He did a lot of like POV stuff, so it was mainly just me and him. But like, there's certain angles and stuff like that, and sometimes we have to stop and like fix lights. And when you're having regular sex, like, we don't have to do that really.
Yeah, you have to worry about the shot.
I do that anyway. Just because I have mirrors.
This is my best side.
Yeah. Don't look up. Don't make eye contact. That's what I do.
Please don't call my mother.
So do you date outside of the industry, or have you had any luck doing that?
Like in comedy
industry?
Oh, well, what's funny is that when I was in porn, like, comedians were like the dudes that I dated a lot, because they didn't care that I was in porn, and they were also like have the same type of issues that that a lot of porn stars do, and just like the lifestyle. So that was great. And then when I got into comedy, everyone's like, don't fuck comics, you know, like,
which is true.
Yeah, like, you're not supposed
that's
to
always say that on
it's
every
not supposed
show.
To. It's just not preferred.
Yeah. And like, I've done it absolutely.
As a comic, or when you
were as a comic. Yeah, okay. And for the most part, it's fine. Like, there's one comic that he's
no names.
No, absolutely no names. He just kind of acts a little awkward because he's not really like the one night stand kind of guy. Like, he has relationships and stuff like that. So now when he sees me, he's very sweet and he like says hello, but he like kind of walks away kind of fast because he doesn't know how to interact with me without wanting to fuck me.
But you guys already dated, or you guys
hooked up a couple of times, and like, we knew like we can't date because of like who he is, like, and stuff like that. And we're just like, I don't want to.
Okay.
But like, honey, I'm like, I don't want to date you. I just want to bounce on your dick a couple of times and then you
can move on.
Yeah.
This is the best interview ever.
You haven't even started. When you're trying to date guys or go out with guys, like, how is it when do they say, oh, by the way, I've seen your work? Like, how does that work?
Well, normally if that happens, I run out the bathroom. Like, I sneak out. No, it's...
the expectations are a little bit different.
Yeah, it is a little bit weird. Like, I definitely try not to sleep with fans is the thing. And I know that there's some comics or whatever that are fans or that were fans and stuff like that. And, like, it's happened a couple of times when, like, be messing around with someone and just like, I gotta tell you, I'm a really big, you know, I was a really big fan, and I'm like, you're gonna have to leave now.
Wow.
Because you have no idea what's gonna happen. And a lot of times, like, they get so nervous that they can't get it up. Like, they get like they get in their head that, like,
I probably would too. Yeah. I mean, it's gotta be intimidating for a guy who has seen you have sex with like guys who are well endowed or like are good at having sex, at least on camera.
Yeah.
And then they're probably, because it never is like on porn, right? I mean, is the sex,
is it better depends. On it, and it, or it off depends. Camera? It depends on who you're working with. Sometimes it is just like a job. Right. You know, we're just like, okay, let's get this anal scene over. I have laundry to do.
Sure.
But other times, like if you're really, like you could be really into it too. Like the director that I dated, sure, that, like we really, it. Like, yeah, we needed the sexual chemistry and the scenes can actually be a lot of fun and girls can orgasm on camera. I know that sounds crazy.
It's a lot technical.
Yeah, a lot of times when you see
it's
girls.
It's on your own, yeah.
Fiddling. Yeah, like, they're trying to get off basically. Okay.
It makes it seem go faster, I suppose.
Yeah, it does help.
Or
well,
happier.
I mean, just like certain positions and stuff like that, like you need clitoral stimulation a lot of times, and so
I say sure, like I know. Oh, of course, yeah. I always do.
It's required. Yeah. Yes.
Do you know where it is, Paul?
I think I do now.
Okay.
I've seen a lot of porn. So.
Yeah, but that's not where you find
it. Yeah.
It's a little more hands-on.
Yeah.
Oh, that's true. Okay. Yeah. I guess I don't know yet. I'm still learning.
Oh, boy. Okay.
No,
I'm going to show you a picture of vagina when we get done with here, and I'm going to show you.
This will be a demonstration for me.
It's too bad.
This is why I'm single.
It's too bad that men are intimidated or can't get it up or appreciate the fact they could probably learn a lot.
Oh, yeah.
Not that you want, but you also don't want to go into any sort of situation where you're now teaching somebody either.
Yeah.
That's work.
Like, I'm not really into that. And there's some guys to be like, I want you to fuck me like a porn star. I'm like, okay.
Oh, no.
And I make them sit on the couch for like 3 hours while I like get ready, like do my hair and makeup.
Yes.
And then I'm like, you could keep it up for 6 hours, right? Like with breaks, and we gotta fix the lights and stuff. You said you want to fuck me like a porn star. We're gonna do it like exactly like on a porn set, and then that kind of scares them a little bit.
Oh, maybe that's why they lose their. Did you do that, and then all of a sudden they went limp? Well,
I think I would too. No, this is actually when like we're messing around, and then like one of them is like, I'm a really big fan of you, and I'm like, yeah, you're gonna have to leave now, because he didn't tell me that before. Like he actually said, he's like, oh, I've never seen your porn, and then he's like, I lied to you, and I'm like, oh yeah, no, you're not going
that's
inside
not a good
me.
Way to start the relationship. No. Have you had people that you've hooked up with not know you from porn?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but I feel bad about that. Like, I feel like I need to tell people for some reason.
How does that happen? Like, how do you bring it up? Or
yeah, what a weird crossroads, because either they're fans of yours,
or they
don't know, and you feel compelled to tell them.
Yeah.
So you're
because
if trapped.
You tell them, they're gonna look it up.
Sometimes there's some guys, like I actually have some guy friends. At least according to them, they're like, now that they know me, they can't watch my porn anymore. If they just met me, they're like, no, that'd be super weird to watch you do porn. And other guys are like, I'm going to Google you right the fuck now. You know, going to the bathroom. And I'm like, let's not do that
while
I'm in the room.
Yeah, no, that's for later. Enjoy later.
When we became friends, I can't watch it. Yeah. I'm like, I know her. So.
Did you know her from before?
I didn't know her work when we met.
Yeah.
I didn't know. And then
I'm trying to place the face, but I I'll have to look as well.
So then you feel compelled to tell them that you have done porn.
Well, yeah.
And how does that affect the relationship, or any, if at all?
Well, I haven't had a relationship. Okay.
So this is just guys you're hooking up with.
Yeah. I've never really, like, for years I haven't really been a relationship type. Like, I haven't really been looking for anything like that. It's not saying that like I can't be monogamous. I can. It's just I haven't found the right person that's like totally deserving of everything that I have to offer. Because not only do I give great blowjobs, but I cook, I clean.
You make them work for it.
Smart.
Like, yeah.
I
earn it.
I do. I am kind of smart. I have
funny.
That
you bring a lot to the table.
I do. Like, it's a big challenge.
But are you only? But you also are you bisexual too, or is that just
pansexual, which is where transsexuals. I'm attracted to transsexuals, women.
The microphone is
apparently
over
the microphone.
I like how she handled that microphone very delicately.
Very
like,
nice. Well, it's a very sensitive piece of equipment.
I can tell. So you were saying, I'm sorry.
Are you going to be okay? Focus, Paul. Focus.
We got to take a break. Did I already mention the sponsors? No, I'm sorry.
No, pansexual, because I have sex with transsexuals and females and males.
Okay. Gotcha.
So all the fun groups, basically.
I needed that explanation.
I didn't know. Yeah, I
heard before. Yes.
Yeah.
But you predominantly will hook up with males, or is it?
Yeah, yeah. Mostly men. There's, like, when it comes with female comedians, like, I have a crush on a female comic right now, but I have too much, like, I have too much respect for my female comedian, so I don't hit on them. But I'll totally bang a male. Like, I don't give a shit. Like, I'm kind of sexist, I've come to realize. It's just like, oh, well, like, guys are good for opening doors and, like, paying for stuff.
Well, also, getting involved physically with a woman is also different, I would imagine, emotionally.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Like, you definitely, you have to be more emotional, and I lack that a lot, like that intimacy.
You don't want to be available emotionally.
Yeah, yeah.
All right,
that's what I hear about myself very often.
Yeah, I'm not good at being vulnerable. That's why. it's not one of my strong suits.
Yeah. I'm like a porn star, but except I don't have any of the skills. I guess
That would put you out of the running.
So how do you meet people now then? If they're not, you know, obviously you're not going to go hook up or date guys who are fans.
Yeah.
So like, what about you talk about it on stage? So.
Luck of the draw, basically. Okay. No, I have a couple of guys that I bang regularly that I have
been in the rotation.
For a couple of years. There's like a couple in LA. I have like one or two in New York. Like I have some in Milwaukee. You know what I mean? So
gotcha.
I have my core group of guys that, you know,
fulfill your needs.
Yeah,
basically. So it depends on where you are and the mood you're in.
Yeah,
obviously, basically. Which makes sense.
Yeah, be like, what do I want to eat for dinner today?
I know you do.
I want that in every city. That'd be great. Damn.
So right, do I want it hot and quick? Do I want it sensual?
Yeah.
That's what you need is a range.
Yeah.
Although it sucks, like when I want to sleep with someone, I'm like, oh, you're all the way in LA. Like I've totally flown to LA just to have sex with somebody and then come back. Well, I mean, they paid for the flight, but yeah. Like when you do enough sexting and you're just like, we need to do it now, and then just.
Has sex changed for you now that, you know, obviously you did it as a job.
Yeah.
So now, like, does it affect your ability? Do you think that's affected your emotional unavailability,
I guess. Well, it definitely helps me come more when, like, because women, they kind of have to have an emotional connection or they, you know, feelings or whatever, especially like to orgasm. And so I've noticed that I don't need to be emotionally connected to a dude to have an orgasm, which is really nice. And that actually took a lot of training.
Really?
Yeah.
How do you train for that?
You just keep doing it until you finally, you know, are like,
oh. It becomes physical, detached from the emotional.
Yeah. Okay. And you're just like, oh, I could do this now. And it's just like you focus more on like coming, basically, because it is like in our heads.
You have to be goal driven, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Goal orientated.
That makes sense.
Makes sense.
I think that's how I am.
Yeah.
Goal oriented.
How are you going to arrive if you don't
in
know?
In everything in life, including completion, I guess. So, so what happens?
But you also need the other person to be as goal driven as you are, though, too, to make sure you get there.
Yeah, like now it's definitely. I think just being older too, and like when you're an older woman, like you know your body more, so and you're more comfortable and have more self-esteem, so it's easier to tell a guy, be like, no, it's more to the left, you know, and not be like embarrassed, because women for some reason are always embarrassed or scared
or just complacent. They're like, I guess this is happening.
Oh, this is what sex is, and like you don't get off or it hurts or something like that, and like you don't know any better. But now, like, I'm definitely more educated in it, and I'm like, now
this is what I need you to do. Yeah, like I get mad.
Do you like that? Do you appreciate
it? I like when people tell me what to do. Because I feel like, well, no, I mean, not like that. it's like, what's the point? So I just feel like it makes more sense to like, I mean, I do it if I'm like, no, that actually hurts or whatever. So like, of course, why shouldn't women do that?
Well, with society and just
societal Puritan ethics.
Yeah, and all like
kill everything.
The stigma about just women enjoying sex in general. Like we're considered whores or dirty. I'm like, I'll be a fucking whore. I came today. Fuck you. You know what I mean?
One a day, I think, is prescribed.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Pretty
I'm
much.
Not a doctor.
Yeah. He's like, I'm only a lawyer. I'm not a doctor.
Yeah. I think that's legally
daily
accurate.
Requirement.
Yeah.
I think it's healthy. It's supposed to be good for your skin.
Well, for men, they say 1 to 5 times, like, masturbating or, like, coming is, like, they need that. Like, it helps with their prostate and, like, prevents cancer and stuff like that. So women, We don't really have that. Like, it's not like a medical need.
It's more for your mood.
Yeah.
The emotional.
And your heart. I think it's good for your heart.
Yeah. It definitely makes me a nicer person.
Makes sense.
For at least a couple of days. Yeah. And then I'm back to normal. Yeah.
So you said you dated the director.
Yeah.
That you had. Were there other porn stars that you dated?
Well, yeah. There was a couple. Like I said, the chemistry was good on set. And then, like, we go out and, like, bang a couple more times or
offset.
Whatever. Yeah.
Okay.
Offset.
And that's kind of helped to create the chemistry, I suppose, right?
Yeah, okay. A little bit, sense. Yeah. There's always, like, takes in between. Like, there's a couple of scenes where we would just mess around, you know, when the cameras weren't going, and then we get in trouble for that a little bit because the guy, like, if he comes too soon and, like, the whole, like, it's the money shot. Like, if you don't have the cum shot, then the scene is gone,
right.
Basically.
And how long does it take I've always wondered about this. How long would it take for them to be able to regenerate, I guess, is the only way.
In the biz?
Well, it depends. It depends on the guy if, like, you know, if they're natural age, you know, if they're, like, taking Viagra or something like that. A lot of that has to do with it. As well,
I would imagine Viagra gets in the way of them being able to achieve.
Yeah, a lot
to crush the finish line.
Yeah, well, a lot of, like, the younger, newer guys, they assume that, like, they have to do that. It's like, no, if you can't do this naturally, like the director that I dated, he was older and was like, he's like all that. He's like, no, if you can't fucking do it naturally, then get the fuck out of this job because it's a tough job for guys.
It's like steroids for football players.
Yeah, well, there's like dudes that used to, like, inject their dicks with, like, certain types of steroids and stuff like that, you know, to keep it hard. And it's just like, oh yeah,
whatever it takes. Hey,
yeah.
Goal oriented.
You got to do it to keep the job, I suppose.
Yeah,
to compete with the younger generation. Probably is it like in that movie?
Well, a lot of the older guys are actually much better performers than the younger guys. Absolutely. And a lot of them, they're more women friendly. Like, there's some guys in porn, like, they don't like women, which is fine because there's some women in porn that don't like men either. And you could tell that, like, in the scene.
They don't like them in the sense that they're disrespectful or that they're gay.
They have mommy issues. Okay. Or, yeah. I mean, they do have, like, gay for pay, it's called. And so there may be straight for pay, too. I've never encountered that, though. Okay. But I'm not saying that it's
But what
not
you're talking about is guys who just didn't give a shit about the girls in the
scene. Yeah, yeah. Like, gotcha. Like maybe even, like, don't care, like, if it's an anal scene, if it hurts, like, he's doing it at the wrong angle or something like that. It's just like, I don't give a fuck. Like, something like that happens.
More
to everyone.
More about how they look and how they come across rather than,
than
it being a two-way street.
Yeah.
Okay.
And so that's always, like, those guys. Like, we have no list, or, like, I had, you know, with people that I would work with and people that I wouldn't work with.
Oh, you could say.
Oh, absolutely. Well, yeah, it's not like sharing a cubicle with somebody. Okay. You know what I mean?
There's no HR department?
Yeah, like,
okay,
no HR department.
There's no grievances. Yeah. That would be a good lawyer job to have. Just be like the adult.
Negotiating
you will
work with.
Porn, yeah.
Like, imagine.
How do I get that gig?
I knew a gynecologist that wanted to work at the, what's the ranch? The bunny ranch?
Oh, bunny ranch.
She wanted to be able to, like, give them exams. She's like, it's a great assembly line, you know, make sure everyone's healthy.
Right. Yeah. And they need checkups regularly, you know, because it's a busy, they're busy.
That was her goal, was to go work someplace like the bunny ranch.
Aim high. Yeah. Goal oriented.
Exactly. That's amazing.
So what? So what about now? Like, after your shows, are you? Because a lot of comedians we've had on that are female comics. Mm-hmm. Guys meet the way guys meet girls is after shows.
Yeah.
A lot of comics have been doing that.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you have that happen? Because you talk about being a porn star on stage.
Yeah.
And stuff, so.
Oh yeah, you have a double whammy because I do stand up comedy.
Yeah.
A lot of guys don't come up to me after shows.
Yeah.
Because they just, you know, it's whatever, if they're intimidated or whatever it is, but then the double whammy of being a comic
and a
being,
porn star.
Yeah,
like,
so
that's
sometimes
gotta be super intimidating.
Yeah, well, we did a show, me and my friend Sovereign, we did a show earlier today in Milwaukee, and I had one of my old strip club customers come in, and then one of just a fan that actually he hung out with us the last time I was in town. And, like, they came up and, like, talked and stuff like that. But there was one guy who was, like, really nervous. He was a fan of comedy, not necessarily porn. He's like, I didn't know what to say. Because he was a fan of both of ours because he heard us on different podcasts and stuff like that. I have some dudes that come up and just like, oh, I liked your work before. Oh, you're very funny. But, like, a lot of times they are, like, intimidated.
Sure.
A lot of guys are really intimidated.
Have you ever hooked up with a guy that spent you at a show, after a show?
No.
No fans?
No.
What if they're a fan of
you? Have you ever hooked up with a fan after a show? We've probably covered this
before. I have,
yeah.
Never but not,
it doesn't happen often because I self-deprecate, and I used to say my age on stage. Now I don't.
Don't do that.
I'm not going to do that because they're like, oh, this guy's creepy.
He just aged himself out of my category.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm already aged out on Tinder, so it's not going to work in two things. So what about if people, you said if they're a fan of your work, obviously you're going to say no. What if they're a fan of your comedy? Will you hook up with a...
That depends on the person. Like, I can't just be like, no, and then all of a sudden be like, you're the perfect person. I end up marrying them, and then I sound like a hypocrite. So no, I'm not. I don't know. I can't say.
Okay.
I can't say.
Do you think you want to get married?
I don't know.
It's not on your
agenda. It's not a goal.
It's not.
You're not goal oriented.
Like my mother, she didn't get married until she was older, you know, like in her 40s and stuff like that. I'm like a couple years away from that. So I'm like, if it happens, it happens. But if it doesn't, it's not something that I'd be like, oh, I missed out on this. Yeah. Like I almost got married when I was younger, a lot younger, in my early 20s. And that relationship was just hell. And so I was like, I don't really know if this is for me.
Yeah.
Like, I don't mind, like, being with someone. I just, like, in the whole marriage thing with, like, it's just...
It's outdated institutions.
Yeah, and the whole, like, piece of paper.
Not Patty, I say.
Well, if she wants to bounce on a dick, she can't do that if she's married. That's
There's no sex in marriage, I heard.
Right? No, there is. There can be.
Scheduled.
There can be. Yeah, like, and it's just that whole thing, like, I don't need a piece of paper to say that I love somebody or that I'm not going to cheat on them or whatever, but if it is cheaper tax-wise, then maybe, you know, if we end up living together or something like that and just makes sense for taxes or finances or something along those lines. And most of the time, that's pretty much really the only reason why. And like, if religion, a lot of times as well, like, you can't have a child out of wedlock or you know, depending on what you believe in. And I'm an atheist, so actually I'm not an atheist, I don't believe in that either. Like, I'm an anti-atheist.
What does that mean?
No, I have no idea.
Anything.
And nothing.
Well, the atheism.
Nothing is real right
now. Because it's the opposite, right? It's opposition. It's like just kind of going along. If you don't identify as an atheist or religious.
I believe, like, spiritual. Like, I believe, I grew up Native American, so I believe that there's an energy and that everything is connected in some way. You know, I believe in karma and stuff like that. Like, whatever you put out in the universe is what you get back, kind of shit.
I believe in that.
Yeah, spiritual versus religion, I think, is
completely
reasonable.
Yeah, and I'm not, but I went to Catholic school. Like, I was baptized Catholic and stuff like that. And I, when I was younger, I went to a bunch of different churches. My dad let me, like, Lutheran and Baptist, Presbyterian. I was just like, they're all saying the same shit, just a different way. And my dad's like, you don't have to go to church anymore. I'm like, sweet. And then that was the end of, like, my stint going to churches and stuff.
Wow.
I was like, thanks.
There you go.
So before you did porn, you were a stripper also.
Yeah. I was a stripper featured dancer for about 6 years. I did that. And that actually finished paying off my degree in police science that I got in my 20s.
Did you meet people when you were a stripper?
After
shows,
after
how does that work?
Waiting in the parking lot when she's walking to her car.
Yeah, that's why I've never. Yeah. How does that work? Like,
no, I've hooked up with like 3 or 4 people that I've met.
They were
at the
customers of yours at the.
Well, yeah, they're just customers in general. Yeah, there's been a couple of times that I did that. But I've also, like, there's been a couple of times that I've been stalked, you know, being a stripper. Like, I've actually had a Chicago sheriff's, like, literally drive, like, follow me home. Like, I worked at this club. It was called the Show Palace in Delavan, Wisconsin. And so it's right on, like, the Illinois Wisconsin border, and I lived it was like 45 minutes away, and he followed me home, and I had to like not go into my apartment building and like, so sorry.
There he goes. I think she knocks over the mic purposely so she can grab it. You can't bounce on that one. Well, maybe you can, just not right now.
Maybe.
Okay.
I'm sorry. he totally like followed, and like, for some reason, I gave him my number. Like, I had two phones.
Sheriff, what?
Well, that, and I had two phones because I would get a lot of regulars and stuff like that because I was a horrible stripper. Like, I hated talking to guys. Like, I was a great dancer. Like, I did that for a very long time, but I just hated talking to dudes. I was always a girl that just sat at the bar and got wasted and somehow made $1,000 because dudes, like the dudes that just wanted to talk to you or whatever, because I could hold a conversation. So I would get a lot of those guys, which was really nice. And this was one of those guys. So I'm like, oh, here's this phone number. Call me next time or whatever. I'll tell you, like, I'll text you my schedule. And that's how I, like, wow, paid rent and shit, yeah, like that. I got a car and, you know, stuff like that. So I had that, and I'm just like, he's like, oh, he's like, well, I lived in Oak Creek. He's like, oh, I'm in Oak Creek right now. And I'm like, what the fuck are you doing? And he's like, oh, no, well, I followed you. I'm like, oh, what, yeah, the fuck? Scary. You followed me home? I'm like, you're a cop. You're a sheriff. Like, do you have any idea how fucking creepy that is right now? Like, think about it. Home? I'm like, if I were to call the Milwaukee Police right. Department right now and be like, there's a dude that just followed me home 45 minutes from a strip club. What do you think that they're going to say about that person?
By the way, he's a sheriff, sure, too. Yeah.
Yeah. And then tell him, and he'd be like, oh, I didn't think about it. And I'm like, yeah, you didn't think are the key words right, yeah, there. You need to turn the fuck around and, yeah, go back home.
And then so you ended up marrying him?
Yeah. No, we're married. I have like 3 kids now. I keep him in the basement where he belongs.
So how do you meet these guys that like you end up hooking up with? If you're not going to meet
fans.
Well,
I'm old fashioned, so I like to meet people on Twitter.
Okay.
Nice.
So you've met people on Twitter?
Yeah. I meet a lot more people. Oh, see, look. There.
I did it too.
Let's see how you do. Oh, well. Not bad.
I mean more people on Tinder. I've actually, Twitter, not Tinder. I've tried, I tried downloading Tinder once. Me and my podcast host, we were going to do an experiment. We were going to do like,
yeah,
like Aaliyah Janine porn star or Aaliyah Janine the real person. And so I made the real person one first because it's like hooked up to your fucking Facebook, which drives, right, me crazy. And it was within like 3 days someone recognized me and then messaged me on Facebook. It's like, oh, we match. Oh. And I'm like, I don't even know. Like, I didn't even open, like, I just downloaded, yeah, it. And all of a sudden they're like, we match. I'm like, I don't even know what that means. And so I was like, okay, experiment over.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Basically, I did try, I recently downloaded Bumble.
Yep.
And I spent a good 2 days just swiping. I was like, he's hot, he's hot, he's hot. And I was like, this is stupid. Like, I don't know. It was just something about it.
So
like,
you never started a conversation with anybody?
Well, there was like two. They were just really stupid too. Because like the females have to start the conversation. Move, yeah. And like, I was a stripper, so I'm good at starting conversations like that. Because, right, I've heard a lot of my guy friends say they don't know how to fucking start a conversation. I'm like, yeah, oh no, I got this. So so that was fine. But there was just like nothing there. I was just like, no. I'd rather just meet somebody in a bar or something.
Or Twitter.
Like or Twitter. Yeah, right. Yeah, well, because that way you can see how fucking, like, if they're super crazy, yeah, you know, you can find out a lot about people via social media, like their, oh, personality.
Yeah. You can do their history and everything. Yeah,
yeah, and stuff like that.
So you'll meet them, then do a background check. I assume you do.
That's
on
fair.
All of them.
Sometimes.
Well, she has to. I assume you.
Sometimes,
I mean, you have to,
I,
right,
do. Well, a lot of times, like, if it's like a friend of a friend or something like that, like, I'll, like, dig in, like, Facebook or whatever and maybe ask a couple questions here or there. But, yeah, a couple of times I do some background checks. I mean, when
As
people...
As you should.
Yeah, absolutely. When people
Google
me,
yeah,
you know, they see literally everything.
Right.
So it's only fair to...
You should be able to do the same.
Yeah, have a little bit of information.
All right, cool. Well, we're out of time.
Okay.
That was awesome.
Thank
Aaliyah,
you so much.
Where can people find you?
Ooh, I have a website, AaliyahJanine.com. You can follow me on Twitter at @TheAaliyahJanine, Instagram, Aaliyah.Janine. I'm now on Snapchat, which is super fun.
Yes.
AJ,
we are Snapchat friends.
Yes. AJDW420, because I'm still a child who smokes marijuana.
Oh, I just got that. Yeah, that's cute.
Thanks.
Cool. Well, thanks so much for stopping by,
Aaliyah.
Yeah,
thanks for having
me.
It was super awesome. It was great.
Pleasure to meet you.
We'll have
Thank
to have you.
You
come back next time you're in town. For
yeah,
sure.
For sure. Definitely.
Lovely.
We want to have you back.
Okay.
Thanks, all.
It's okay. I'm going to Google you. That's all right.
Yeah.
Thank
you. Thanks so much.
I need to learn some stuff. Go ahead.
Yeah. No, I was just saying thanks, right, everyone, for listening to Singles Only and watching, too. I forgot we were watched for this one, too.
I know.
I forgot. Oh, there's a camera right in my bad side.
Right there. It's not your bad side. Just turn a little bit more that way.